Thank you, Mr. President. I'm speaking today on behalf of the Society for Threatened Peoples. 120,000 people. That is the number of Uyghurs currently being arbitrarily detained in re-education camps in just one prefecture, Kashgar, in the Uyghur Autonomous Region in China. In 2017, it became apparent that thousands of Uyghurs were being rounded up by Chinese authorities and sent to re-education camps around the region. Those detained in camps have been charged with no crime, not provided a trial, and have no access to legal remedies. In the camps, detainees are subjected to political indoctrination classes aimed at eroding the ties to their religion, culture, and ethnic identity. The conditions in the camps are very poor, and at least three Uyghurs have reportedly died under mysterious circumstances. One of them, an 82-year-old man, scholar and religious leader, Mohammed Salih Hajim. The sheer scale of this is astounding. Estimates of the current number of Uyghurs detained in these camps range from 800,000 to 1 million. Nearly every family in the Uyghur diaspora has friends or loved ones currently detained in these camps. Innocent people, mothers, fathers, husbands and wives have all disappeared. Their families are becoming increasingly desperate and frustrated by their inability to save them. They're looking for support from the international community, but have been met with resounding silence. Where is the outrage? Where is the solidarity? Hundreds of thousands of human beings are suffering and the majority of states have remained silent. What happened to the moral imperative to care about the lives and well-being of people who live far away from you simply because they're human? What sort of international community do we want to be? Thank you.
I thank you, sir.